Hello, I'm Troy Roach. I'm a citizen scientist researching low-dose nicotine patches for long COVID and other post-viral illnesses. Today, I want to clarify some confusion regarding the spike protein and snake venom. Just a quick reminder, everything I share is my opinion, not medical advice. There are no magic cures, and smoking is bad for you. Now I'm going to show you this short clip from Dr. Artis, and I'll see you on the other side.
Go to pubmed.gov and type in rabies and homologous, H-O-M-O-L-O-G-O-U-S, to snake venom. Now listen to me. You've all heard in this interview that the word virus in Latin means poison, especially of snake's venom. Now you're learning that the rabies virus, it has one spike protein, and it is published by scientists to be homologous, which literally means one of its definitions is identical to, the rabies spike protein is identical to snake venom neurotoxins.
Dr. Artis often says the spike protein is snake venom. That sounds shocking, and it grabs attention, but scientifically, it's not quite right. Here's the more accurate version. Parts of the spike protein are homologous to certain peptides found in snake venom. Homologous does not mean identical. It means the protein shares similar structure in certain segments. That's it. Think of it like this. Two keys might look very similar, but they don't open the same lock. They're homologous, but not interchangeable. This misunderstanding is actually a big reason why many doctors and scientists dismiss low-dose nicotine patch research. The word virus actually comes from the Latin word for venom or poison. So yes, there's a real historical connection there, but the way it's often presented, suggesting the SARS-CoV-2 is venom, crosses into conspiracy territory, and that's what gets dismissed. I appreciate your effort to raise awareness, but the wording is holding nicotine research back. We need precision. If you want the research that Dr. Leitzke and I are doing into nicotine to be taken seriously. But when the science is misrepresented, even slightly, it closes doors instead of opening. We already have to climb a big hurdle to get over the misguided stigma around nicotine. Let's get the language right, because that's how we get real research, real funding, and real support for the people who are still sick and waiting. Take care of yourself, and if you can, take care of someone else too. I'll see you in the next video.